house, isn't it? I wanted to enjoy the rain with you because rain is something that I have always found very, very soothing. I did not grow up in an area where it rained a lot, so having the rain was quite special.
Sided dice, and if you roll a 19 or a 20, that
they would win, basically, or they would just, like, destroy, and it kind of makes a common enemy on the table, so everybody will kind of attack the person that has Thanos, and that just kind of gets in the way of the, gameplay sometimes, because a lot of people will, like, be like, oh, I'm just gonna back off, I'm not gonna attack right now because somebody else is attacking him, so I'm just gonna stay back and let them attack him, and then I'll go attack him. But it's like, I would just rather it not be everybody against that one person, you know? And that's kind of how it's been in the past. We've played with him a lot, and that's kind of just how it's been in the past, so we have kind of disbanded the Avengers and the Marvel characters a little bit, made them a little bit less powerful. I have seen on Reddit that some people will actually, like, only allow one Marvel character per army, but I don't like to inflict a lot of rules on the game, because then it's just like, I like it whenever you pick a, like, you know, that's like part of the game is picking your army. So if you pick your army incorrectly, you don't deserve to win the game, okay? If you pick your army correctly, you deserve to at least do good. And so that's like a huge part of the game, is if you do not pick the correct players for your army, the right cards, then it's your fault. You know, maybe you should have taken a little bit more time to look through the cards and, like, strategize, because it's a huge strategy game. Huge strategy. I mean, there's unlimited possibilities of what kind of army you can put together. I mean, there's so many cards, there's so many expansion packs for this, and I have only bought, like, a couple of expansion packs, but I would love to buy, like, you know, the whole HeroScape collection of the game, the whole thing, every single expansion pack, every single thing. And you can actually buy, people have made their own fan created characters, and so people have actually created their own characters on the game. We actually have a character that one of my roommates' moms made for us. It's a sloth, and it's so cute. It makes it so that if you are four spaces from the sloth, within four spaces, you can't attack anybody within those four spaces. You know what I mean? So, like, a radius. So the sloth is here, and then four space radius around the sloth is peace zone, you know? So you can't actually, like, attack anybody within that area. And then another thing that he does is he will hug people. So if, you know, he's slow, so he only has two move per turn, but he has really high lives just because of what he is, you know? So he has, like, four lives, two move. His attack is nothing, but his specials are amazing. I mean, like, he is a great character to have because he just kind of throws in a little weirdness. Another one of his abilities is, one of his specials is, if you're within 20, or no, so he can hug you and slow you down. So if he's hugging you, you can only move two spaces at a time until you are out of his reach, okay? But that's the thing, is you can move twice, and he can has two moves, so he can just keep following you, and you're only restricted to two moves per turn if he is on your back. And that, I love that, because some players have a move of, like, seven, and so if you limit that player's move, then you limit that whole army's mobility, you know, because they're not gonna wanna put their order markers on a card that only has the ability to move two spaces at a time because the sloth is chasing it. But, you know, that's just, like, an example of all of the things. Like, that's such a simple army HeroScape is just, it's a really fun game. I first got introduced to it in like 2019, I want to say. I was at a party at my friend's house and they had it set up in the living room. They had been playing it all day and they were still playing it when the party was going on, and it was so entertaining. It was like you were at like this little kid's birthday party. It was really fun and it really brought us like back to our childhood a little bit. And I think that it's actually, it's been almost 5 years now that I've been introduced to HeroScape, and it is one of the most fun tabletop RPGs I've ever played. I mean, granted, it's like the only tabletop RPG that I've ever played, but it's so fun. It is so, so, so immaculately fun. And you can like make pacts with each other. So we actually have this rule. It's a silent pact. So it's non-spoken. It is a eye contact kind of thing, and you can't really verbalize out loud unless it is stated before the game starts that you can make alliances, but we usually veto that out because it's just, it kind of sucks whenever you get ganged up on. It just kind of ruins the game. But no, you can make verbal pacts like, okay, I'm not gonna attack you this round because I don't want you to attack me and I'm retreating, you know. And a lot of people take that and they're like, okay, I'm not gonna attack you. But that's kind of lost where I was going. Lost my train of thought for a second. We'll take a break from the rambling on that. But, ganging up on each other. You can, we have glyphs. We use the glyphs in the game. So there are pit traps. They suck. Pit traps suck so much. The pit traps will, if you land on a pit trap, you are stuck and you cannot move until your teammate, one of your teammates comes and like pulls you out. So they have to get next to you and pull you out. But anybody can pull you out of the pit trap. It does not have to be one of your teammates. So it's fun because sometimes you'll be like, hey, if you come pull me out, I will help with your attack on that person. But it can't be truces. You can't make truces in the game. You can only make temporary little side alliances, but like you can't do it the whole game. It's not allowed. So that's probably what I'm gonna do this weekend, is play HeroScape with my friends on Saturday, because why not? It sounds like a fun time and I haven't done it in a while, so I'm gonna have all of them come over and we're gonna get some drinks going and some smoke going. And also, you guys, I have been in the process of starting a Patreon. I will be uploading more exclusive ASMR content onto my Patreon. This will include, you know, like the stuff that I can't do on YouTube, such as partaking in herbal medications, you know. I would love to do ASMR that is green involved, so I will be posting that on my Patreon. But that is not up yet. I will definitely let you guys know when it is up. It should be before next week sometime. I will have that video up on Patreon and I will start promoting it to you guys. It will only be $5 a month, so it is not like, it's just for more exclusive content that I can't post on YouTube. Obviously, that's usually what people use Patreon for, isn't it? Okay. Thank you so much for watching. I love you so much, and I hope that you sleep really well, and I hope that you are as excited for HeroScape as I am. And if you're not, you should probably check that out because it is hands down one of the best games to play. I love it so much. Okay. Sleep good, sleep good, sleep good.